This video is prepared by Avya Classes. Please subscribe the channel, raise your doubt and watch the video for sure success in JEE, AIIMS and NEET.
So the next problem is that a force F is equal to 2i plus 5j plus k newton is acting on a particle. The particle is first displaced from the point 0, 0, 0 to 2, 2, 0 along the path x is equal to y, and then from 2, 2, 0 to 2, 2, 2 along the path x is equal to 2 and y is equal to 2. The total work done along this complete path will be. So first we will try to solve this problem along the traditional method, and afterwards we will try to solve this problem fast by using an alternate method which is applicable in the examination. So first we will draw the figure pertaining to this problem, and it is says that the object was initially at the point origin, that is 0 0 0, and then it moves to a point, it moves to the point x is equal point 2 2 0 along the path x is equal to y. So there must be some work done in this process, and you have to calculate this work done and term it as w1. Afterwards this object moves along the z axis, that is outward the plane, and goes through a distance equal to 2 meter. So the object just come out of this plane and goes through a distance equal to 2 meter, and you have to calculate the work done in that process which is equal to w2, and the going through this path will be along the path x is equal to 2 meter and y is equal to 2 meter, because it means that when the object comes out of the plane for a length equal to 2 meter at during that time, it's only z component changes, its x and y component remains the same, and you just calculate work done in the second process also. So first we will calculate the work done when the object moves from the point 0 0 0 to 2 2 0 along the path x is equal to y. So our usual method will be, for a displacement, suppose the object has already covered a displacement equal to s, and then cover a infinitesimal small displacement equal to ds. So ds is equal to dx I plus dy j, as the z component remain equal to 0 if the object moves in a planar path or the in the plane. So we get dx is equal to dxi plus dyj, and for the infinitesimal work done, dw is equal to f dot ds, and it is equal to 2i plus 5j plus k dot dxi plus dyj. So the value comes equal to 2dx plus 5dy. So work done w1 will be integration of this dw, and the value comes equal to twice dx plus 5dy. Now what will be the limit of integration? The limit will be 0 0 to 2 2. So if I put the value in this way, that 2dx, here the variable is dx, so we will see only the change in x, and change in x is from 0 to 2. Similarly for 5dy, we consider the change in y only, and it is 0 to 2. So the value comes equal to 2x limit is 0 to 2 plus 5y limit is 0 to 2. So 4 plus 10 is equal to 14 joule. So W1 becomes equal to 14 joule. Now we will move the we will calculate W2, that is work done by object when it moves from the point 220 to 222. And in this case w to v, we again consider that the object has already moved a distance equal to s, and then an infinitesimal displacement equal to ds. So here also ds first will be calculated for the w2. Ds will be what? Dxi plus dyj plus dzk. So if you see this, the movement along this, then x and y components remains constant. So change in x, that is dx, will be zero, as x and y are constant for this second part. Then dx is equal to zero and dy equal to zero, and ds is equal to dzk. So dw will be f dot ds, and it is 2i plus 5j plus k into dzk. So the value will be dz. And work done, w2 is equal to integration of dw, and the value is will be dz, limit will be 0 to 2, and the answer will be z limit 0 to 2, so will be equal to 2 joule. So total work done w1 plus w2, and it is equal to 14 plus 2 joule, that is 16 joule. So answer will be 16 joule. So this is our method when we solve it by breaking the total work into two parts. We may use these two movements combined, and in this way we write ds is equal to dx plus dxi. I just solve it here also. Dxi plus dyj plus dzk. We just consider whole motion combined, because here force is given as a constant. So and f dot dx is equal to for a small displacement dw, f dot ds. So dxi plus dyj plus dzk into value of f is 2i plus 5j plus k. So the value of total work done will be integration of dw, and it is 2dx plus 5dy plus dz, and limit will be 0 0 0 to 2 2 2. We just consider initial point and final point directly. So we just break it into two part. 2dx limit 0 to 2 plus 5dy limit 0 to 2 and plus dz limit 0 to 2. So answer comes equal to 16 joule. So in both way you can be solved. If you want to visualize this problem clearly, then just first draw this figure and try to understand it, how the object moves, and calculate the work done in both cases, that is along this path x is equal to y and along this path. And during examination time you just apply this method, that calculate the work done for the entire path by making the limit from 0 0 0 to 2 2 2 and calculate the work done. The next problem is that it's a very good problem indeed, that the force acting on a particle is 2i plus 3j newton, and work done by this force will be 0 when the particle is moved on the line 3y plus kx is equal to 5. You have to calculate the value of k. See, here the problem says that the particle is moves along a line. Suppose the particle moves along, so I just draw first line, that the particle suppose moves along this line, and this line equation will be given as 3y plus kx is equal to 5. Force is given by 2i plus 3j newton, and you have to calculate the work done by this force will be 0. So when the work done by any force will be 0, it is possible when the force and displacement both are perpendicular to each other, that is when force is perpendicular to displacement. In this case the work done will be 0. So you just calculate the line along which force is acting. Suppose if the force will be acting in such a way, suppose the force will be acting in such a way and the object is moving in this way. So in this case we may say that the displacement or the work done by this force will be zero if the angle between force and displacement will be 90 degrees. So what you will do, you just first calculate the slope of this line and term it equal to m1. So m1 is the slope of line along which displacement occurs, and m2 is the slope of line on which the force occurs. And you just take the concept of mathematics that for two perpendicular lines, for two perpendicular lines having slope m1 and m2, m1 into m2 is equal to minus 1. So force is along this line. So how we will calculate the slope of this line? It means that force is along the line, that is for F is equal to 2y, that is the force is 2 along the x axis, the y component of force is will be equal to 3. So force will be, so we just have to calculate the slope of this line, that is force will act along this line, that is for x component 2, the value of force, the y component of force will be 3. So you just first get the slope of this line, it will be the slope of force line. So m2 is equal to 3 minus 0 divided by 2 minus 0, and slope of force line will be equal to 3 by 2. Now you calculate m1 will be equal to it's given that 3y plus kx is equal to 5, and 3y is equal to 5 minus kx, and y is equal to minus k by 3 plus 5 by 3, k by 3 into x plus 5 by 3. So slope of this line, or slope of displacement line, will be m1 is equal to minus k by 3. So what we get m, we have already calculated m1, slope of displacement line, we have already calculated m2, slope of force line, and what we do, we just multiply these two and equate equal to minus 1. So minus k by 3 into 3 by 2 is equal to minus 1, and k is equal to 2. So answer comes k is equal to 2. So this way we can solve it problem. We can solve it into another way also, that suppose the force is given and the displacement is also given along the line, and you have to calculate it, the value of k. So what you will do, you just use this first displacement equation, which is given as 3y plus kx is equal to 5, and if you differentiate this equation, what you will get, this is our second method, 3dy plus kdx is equal to 0, and from there we get dy is equal to minus kdx by 3. Now force, now work done will be equal to, or the small work done, if this force is making a small displacement equal to ds, then the dw will be f dot ds, and f is given equal to 2i plus 3j, and a small displacement is dxi plus dyj. So it is equal to 2dx plus 3dy. And you just put the value of dy from this equation. So 2dx plus 3 into minus k by 3dx. So its value comes equal to 2 minus kdx. So dw is equal to 2 minus kdx. Now if you integrate this W, then if you integrate it, you will get the total work done. So W is equal to 2 minus K into dx, and integration limit will be the change in value of x. So clearly, for work done to be 0, this term should be equal to 0. So when this term will be equal to 0? When k is equal to 2. So when k is equal to 2, the work done will be 0. So any problem can be solved by different methods also. It depends on that what it suits you. So basically, if you can solve this problem by using our traditional method of work calculation and see that when this work will be 0, or you just calculate the slope of two lines and the product of slope will be equal to -1 for perpendicular lines, and for when the force will be perpendicular to displacement, the work done will be equal to 0. The next problem is that a particle of mass 0.5 kg is displaced from position r1231 to r2 by applying a force of magnitude 30 newton, which is acting along I plus j plus k. The work done by this force is, so basically force is given and two position vectors r1 and r2 are given, and you have to calculate the work done by this force. So as we know that if the initial position vector is r1 and it is equal to 231, that is their components are 2, 3 and 1 respectively along x, y and z axis, and similarly r2 is equal to 4, 3, 2, then from there we can get the displacement, and displacement s is given by the position vector r2 minus r1. So it can be shown in this figure. Suppose the particle is initially at this point r1 and move to another point r2, then this is our displacement. And how we calculate? This is our first position vector and this is our second position vector r2. So clear, and this is our displacement. So clearly r1 plus s is equal to r2, and s is equal to r2 minus r1, that is displacement is the change in position vectors. So if we use calculation, then 432 minus 231 and the value comes equal to 201. So the displacement s is equal to 2i plus 0j plus k. Again, the force is given equal to, force is acting along I plus j plus k. So first we'll calculate the unit vector along the force. So unit vector along the force, we just take the vector and divide it by its magnitude. So magnitude is square root 3. Now it is given that the magnitude of this force is 30 newton. So clearly force is equal to 30 into unit vector along this force, and it is equal to 30 divided by square root 3 into I plus j plus k. So the value comes equal to 10 root 3 I plus j plus k. So we get the value of force, we get the value of displacement. So we will have to just calculate the work done, and work done comes equal to W is equal to F dot ds or F dot s, and is 10 root 3 I plus j plus k dot 2i plus k. So from there we get its value is equal to 10 root 3 into 2 plus 1 and 30 root 3. So the answer comes, or the work done, is equal to 30 root 3 joule. So the work done will be 30 root 3 joule, and if you see the options, the answer will be B.